Back home, hundreds of young Tibetans are reporting to Delhi from all over the country to join protests at Jantar Mantar for their homeland. Saransh Sugandh spends 24 hours with one of them to share the spirit and the cause.
Nawang's cries may not be heard across the border, but he's determined to speak up. He hasn't seen his parents since they convinced him to leave Lhasa as a child with his uncle. He has an 8-year-old sister he's never met.
Yeah, my parents stay in Tibet. I don't know whether they are stay alive or not. I don't have phone connection. They don't have phone connection. For almost one month, I have no link with my family.
Nawang has just arrived in Delhi from Karnataka, but his days ahead are already planned. He arrived with 150 other students who have just finished their board exams. Most of them reached out to each other on email and fixed to meet in the capital.
For today, we are having a peaceful march silence just before hours ago. And then for tomorrow, we're going to have a cycle march. And for third day, we're having the same like this. And we'll see what we're going to do next after 3 or 4 days.
Close friendships have already been formed. He's met Tenzing and Yondak, who he now shares a room with in a Delhi guest house. But they go there only to sleep. Waking hours are spent like this.
We are chanting Taras mantra. We are chanting for the since our people are dying in Tibet, and so therefore we are. This is sort of, you know, mourning, you know, so for the well-being of those dead people.
As Nawang joins these non-violent protests, he says the police seems to have little respect for his group.
And in between, you know, when I stick those stickers in metro station, I've been interacting with police, and they were so, you know, harsh to us, you know, because they thought that we are doing some sort of, you know, violence. But we want our freedom, you know, with through peace, you know. If government cannot do it, that's okay, because government are pressurized by China. But people are not pressurized by people.
Nawang says he can't allow us to see where he stays or sleeps. His friends speak of others like him being rounded up, so an 18-year-old who has nothing to hide has to bid us goodbye. Before he leaves, he says he hopes to someday be a businessman, but there's something he wants much more.
Tibet Freedom Corps will never die. I may become a businessman, but still, you know, I have to fight for our freedom till our freedom is not regained from the Chinese rule, you know. I may have to die for it, but I'm ready for it.
With counterperson Rishi and Naresh, in New Delhi, Saransh Sugandh for NDTV.